Hey guys, gals, friends, and pals. This is Paul Acevedo from Windows Central. Welcome to another episode of Saturday Game School, where we learn about a different game or games every Saturday of the year. Tonight I'm joined on the mic by Brian and Tyler.
Yo.
Hello.
That's right. And right next to me I have special guest India, who's going to help out with Stickbold for a minute. Tonight we're looking at a bunch of different games from the Instant Indie Hits bundle, which is available on Xbox One for a limited time. It's from Curve Digital and Microsoft. They've partnered to create this bundle of 10 different indie games to offer this bundle. I mean, 10 games for $20. That's $2 a game. It is a super good deal. Even if you already own a couple of those games, it's still a good deal. So.
Yeah, definitely.
And I have about six of them, I think. And we're going to look at as many of those as we can. So now we're playing Stickbold, a dodgeball adventure. Let's just do... Can we do story? Well, we got all these different slots. I think we...
Hey, Douglas.
Let's try this one.
No time.
Okay, push A, India. Yo, no time for games. Good to see you. Welcome, Smooth Douglas. Here goes. So it looks like No, I haven't quite beaten the game in co-op, so we're going to jump in and fight this devil guy. We'll just see how that goes.
Cool. Lightspeed.
Yeah, the interesting thing about Stickbold is it has a full story mode with a humorous, silly story. Like, the writing is not great, but it is nice and silly.
It's a game about dodgeball. I mean, come on.
Lightspeed Halo. Yeah, you know, there's a movie, Dodgeball, which is quite a funny movie, and I still find it rewatchable. And so here you have a game about dodgeball, and it's kind of funny, too.
Hmm. Well, on the face of it, dodgeball is a bit of a silly activity.
So we're spoiling a story twist here. Sorry, guys. But yes, your coach turns out to be the devil.
Some of that groovy,
yeah.
Honey. I like this.
Oh, God.
Very wry sense of humor.
Evil
like
coach.
That.
Okay, he's just evil coach. So he's just a demon, I guess. Yo, Perfect Zero, good to see you. Let's see. By the way, Brownmeister and I... Okay, we got to use left trigger to dodge or catch the ball, I believe, and right trigger to throw it. Throw it at him.
Oh, my.
Did you hit him? Oh, he caught it. All right. Charge it, then throw it. Did he take a hit from that? Ow.
Yeah, he did. Pass it.
Wait, I want to hit. Okay. Ah! Oh, you gotta bring me back to life, India.
Ooh!
Okay, don't get knocked down, bring me back. Yeah, this has two-player local co-op. It also has four-player local competitive, which, of course, you would want in a dodgeball game. No online. It's an indie game. Ah, crap! Alright, how do I revive you? Just stand next to you? Okay. No!
Stand behind the rock!
Alright.
Run away!
Yeah, there's some kind of trick to this that we need to figure out.
Yeah, I think you're damaging.
I don't know, his life might be going down a little. I think he just has way too much.
Oh, yeah, maybe.
Yeah, his life goes down a very small amount when you hit him.
Right. I didn't even notice that he had a life bar down there.
Yeah, false cover.
Sorry about that.
Oh,
don't step in the lava. We just learned that. I should have known. Alright, she's bringing me back. Good girl. Thank you. Ah!
Hey.
Let's see. So the controls are really good in this. They're quite intuitive, you know. You got your dodge and catch button, and you can use that to dash around. And your throw button, and you can aim and throw any way you want. And you charge your shot up and hit him when you get the ball. You have to charge it. You hold the right trigger. And throw it. Ah!
Yeah.
Okay. Oh. There's a lot of unlockable characters, too, which is good for the local multi.
The thing at the top of the screen is telling you.
Oh,
what
does it say to do?
Charge you, get him to charge into the rocks.
Oh, okay, we want him to run into the rocks, India. There we go.
Beat him up!
We messed up the speedrunner. Okay, and then just hit him a lot. I guess he's vulnerable at that time.
Yeah.
Hey, that's not.
Are you throwing rocks at him now? Jeez, Paul.
Oh, God. Ah! Good.
Hit him!
Okay. Yeah, they did a lot more damage.
Kick him in the face!
I'm real out of practice on this. Of course, I played through it and beat it for a review. I'm just out of practice is all. Yeah, hurry and get to me. We don't want to have to continue. Don't let him get you. Don't let him get you. Dodge it. Yes. Okay.
It's called
Ah! God! Oh no, he just killed us both. That was so cheap.
Oh,
we're gonna try one more time.
Yeah, nice.
We didn't know what to do at first. I was, and now we do, so that'll help. Yes, he is barfing and crapping fire. He's a bad guy.
And this is
not all like fanciful matches. There's plenty of matches against regular people and stuff. It's just that the story has led up to this. Alright. Wait, I'm gonna...
It's always interesting when the story leads up to this point. Where you're fighting the devil with a dodgeball.
That's what he gets.
That looks like Santa Claus.
He does.
Yeah. Ah. Santa Claus
this game was developed in Poland. And, you know, I quite like Poland and many Polish developers. But it's not untrue that every single man, woman, and child in Poland looks like Santa Claus. There, I said it.
Okay.
True facts! That's real news. It's not fake news. All right.
Mm-hmm.
And for saying fake news, I now have to stand in the corner for 20 minutes.
Yes, you do. Bad call. Don't throw rocks at
your dad. Wow. Rocks right there.
Oh, great. He got the ball. Watch out. Good. Come on. We're going to do this. India says he's a cheater. There we go. Oh, dang it. Wasn't hard enough. Charge it. You got the ball. All right.
Icky, I don't ever remember Colonel Sanders wearing short shorts and throwing out.
Colonel Sanders...
What
are you doing, Bjorn? What is that? Ah, that means we completed some kind of mini objective. Stop shooting rocks at me, God. No, oh, he killed India. No.
Jeez, Paul, you're letting the team down.
Fault. I mean, he was focused on me. She got hit by nothing.
No.
All right, we're gonna do this.
It's because she was
dead,
Paul.
She has to say, like, rescue me, you know? Okay, I'm down. If you just happen to be near where that lava pools up, you're in trouble. Get to me. No, get to me. India, come on, we don't want to... Get over here, silly. Thank you.
Hurry up and get behind the rock.
Okay, we've got it this time. I don't want to be behind the rock. I want the ball.
You might be right there, Icky. I think this might be a continuation from a previous playthrough of this.
I mean, of course. I picked a save file.
No, I mean on stream.
Oh, I see. Well, that's neat, if so.
It might be.
We did stream it once. Ah.
Yeah, I remember that stream. That was
the original
crazy.
Stream was set up by our friend Cody, who works in PR. And now I think a different company handles Curve's PR, or at least the PR for this particular bundle.
Help me, rescue!
Ah.
Rescue!
Coming. Okay. Quick, hit him!
Eat him!
I threw it the wrong way, aim at him.
Sorry.
Not each other.
Don't get hit by these, God.
Oh, I hit him in the butt.
Nice throw. He had that coming. Ay, ay, ay. No.
Ah!
That didn't work well.
Oh, all right. I'm so blind.
We've got this. After this, I think we're going to do 10-second Ninja X real quick. Because it's nice
cool.
And short. I mean, the levels are anyway. It's actually pretty long.
Well, I mean, that's kind of in the name.
Right. Oh, no, get away. Don't be close to each other.
Don't choke, Paul.
That was scary.
Ah,
yeah, we got that spike ball to worry about. That's the hard part. That's what got India last time.
Jeez.
Oh, and he's doing the lava run. Yes, he hit the rock. Throw it at him. Get him. We did it. Yes. All right.
Hey, all right.
Complete challenge.
It's nice actually watching the stream in almost real time.
Yeah. Game's been a lot quicker with the delay.
Yeah, it really makes the co-hosting experience better, doesn't it? I'm sure. We unlocked the devil as a playable character.
Yeah, it does.
He's just a devil. He's not the devil.
Hey, withheld.
Thanks, Withheld.
Yeah, he's just a dude.
Right. That there. Was all. India, tell everybody goodnight. No, we can't do another. I have to switch games. Say goodnight.
Goodnight.
Okay, silly.
Au revoir. All
right. Here. Put the controller down. Games and apps. Now for 10 Second Ninja X. So that's one of the games you get in this bundle. Really, you're pushing buttons. Leave it alone. Okay. One of the games you get in this bundle. The only one with local multiplayer that I know of. So I've just clicked on just getting your game ready. Does anyone else's Xbox One do this? Like...
You have 400 games installed, Paul, so...
You know, I mean, I'm... I don't know. I'm not that the only one with it. A big collection. You know, Cecil Kilmer has a big collection. Of course, even if he had a problem with, like, issues like this, he probably just wouldn't say anything about it. Kind of toes the party line, for better or worse.
Mm.
Nice. Lockdown has just as many Steam games, he says. Here we are, 10 Second Ninja X. Didn't we have the actual developer on
Same
the mic of this when we streamed this one, or did we not? I forget.
Maybe.
Yeah, every now and then... That's a fun thing about our stream. Every now and then we have developers guest co-host with us, and that was really cool. So I just want to jump into an early level and just see what they're like. So basically, you got a super villain dude. Oh boy, I don't remember anything. All right, retry level. There's India signing out. Okay, that's real annoying, India. That can't be the very first level. Hey, I just got an achievement. Just getting started. Earned 25 stars. It must not have popped at the right time before.
Yeah.
Oh, look at that. Smashing. I'm getting all kinds of achievements just for starting the game.
You guys should just start up all your games. Xbox likes to not unlock achievements, so just start up all your games.
That does happen every now and then. So yeah, here's the actual first level. Bam. Next level.
Aha.
Yeah, I'm not trying to pick up where I left off because I'm too out of practice and this is a hard game.
Yeah, that would be really difficult.
Yeah, I forget if there's an actual dash move.
You have three throwing stars. I just don't remember how you throw them, but you should figure out what button that is.
Yes! Yeah, and I would have died right there if I hadn't done it.
Nice. Okay.
It's kind of like, I mean, there is a platforming challenge to it in the later levels especially, but there's also some puzzling about figuring out which route you have to take to get the three-star
Yeah, very
cap.
Much so.
Like, and where Definitely. To use your throwing stars versus where to use your
Crap.
Sword.
Retry level. Did you actually beat it, Tyler?
I beat it. I didn't get all the stars, but yeah, I beat the game. I didn't do all of the whole first game is actually unlocked. Because I guess the first game was kind of like a free flash game, and then this is an enhanced, you know, or built from that. But the whole first game is available when you beat the core version
really
of this.
That's really cool.
It is cool. I can't beat all the levels, though.
Okay, this is going to take a little figuring out.
Don't waste your throwing stars.
That time, I got it right. Next level. Is it like a... I mean, it was not designed for mobile. Yeah, mobile.
I don't think.
Yeah,
so. It kind of, I mean, it looks like it, but this seems way too twitchy to be.
Wasn't
a mobile
this designed
game.
By just one guy?
Yeah, this is.
I don't know. I'm sure it wasn't a big team.
Whoops. Yeah, let's try this again. I mean, but like, yeah, it's not particularly mobile-esque, and also it's actually a really good game. It may not look too amazing, but it's quite fun.
Yeah,
yeah I think it looks pretty good.
All right.
Hey, Link.
Oh, God. This level's hard. Maybe I'll call it quits after this level.
I mean, it's a pretty good demo of the game.
Yeah. There we go. Yay! And let me hop back to the ship real fast. It's got a little hub world here. When you get enough stars, you unlock new sections of levels. But there's actually a lot of different stuff to look around and see.
Yeah, there's a whole little secret minigame, too, that you can unlock by... collecting all the little discs.
Yeah, here's Great Beard Arcade. We'll just hop in and take a fast look at that. What do I push to do it?
I think you have to collect them all first. I don't know if you
Quinn, I've definitely done the mini game before, unless there's more than one.
Oh. No, there's just one.
Okay, you have to talk to her, that's it. Play said yes.
Oh, yeah, no, this isn't. You're right, there's more than
one. Okay, well, whatever.
I forgot about the Crate Smasher one.
Yeah, there's different things to explore and collectibles to find. Here's a little hidden area back here. What's back here? Secret area discovery.
Yeah, see, you have seven out of the nine discs, or pieces of the disc
found. Go back and find them sometime. Welcome, Big Loser. Good to see you. Are you actually from Hawaii? Because that would be pretty neat. We need a regular Hawaiian viewer.
Yeah, that would be cool.
That would be cool. Although they're, 6 hours behind Eastern time?
They can't be that far. I mean, they're on Pacific time and then back an hour, right? So...
No, go back 2 hours.
Okay. So, yeah, it'd just be early afternoon for them. It would be fine.
California.
Yeah, so that was, I guess, real quick, Stealth Inc. And after that, Hugh, and finally the Swindle. And that'll be a good lineup.
It's sad that you have so many games, you actually have to use the find feature.
I'm not sad about it. Stealth Inc. 2, A Game of Clones. I reviewed this for our site as well. And tonight's stream article links to all of our reviews. Like, I only personally reviewed maybe, like, three of them, and somebody else did a couple of them. But any of these games that we've reviewed, you can find those just going through our stream article. So please check out those reviews if you would like to know more about these games. And as always, commenting on the reviews is really good for us, so please do that. Yeah, indeed. Anybody who actually comments on one of these old reviews gets a star. So just remember that. Next week you can say, hey, Paul, I commented on that review and I want my star. That's how it's going to work. Yo, Sergeant Torrente, good to see you. What size hard drive do I have? Lockdown asks. My system is an Xbox One S with a 1 terabyte, and then I have a 4 terabyte connected to it. And I guess I have like...
So five.
Yeah, it's five in total. Nice. And I've got about 700 free, I think. 700, yeah.
Jeez.
So... Boy,
it's crazy.
Adds up quick.
So this is a hard game to jump back into as well, because you've got this really complex, large overworld. It's a little, they described it as Metroidvania-like. It is slightly in some ways.
A little bit.
I kind of wish I could just start at the beginning to show people, but then I would lose my progress. I don't want that. But I think I had saved right next to a level, so we'll go into the level. But yeah, there's a lot of stuff to find and an interesting story that develops. It's not told in the very best way, but the actual story is kind of interesting, so I like that. So let's jump into this level.
Yeah, I think I almost liked the original more, how they were just self-contained levels. I didn't feel like the overworld added a ton.
Well, it had some time, doesn't it? But, yeah.
Yes, it does. Yeah, I actually got lost a couple times.
I see that. Oh, all right. That guy drops down and shoots me. I want to get him...
He dropped right on you.
Oh, I see. You have to get him on that, then hit... Oh, he has to be all the way on it. Now what? Now what do I need him to do?
Angry old gamer followed
the
channel.
Yay, thank you for the follow. What are you so angry about, old gamer?
Well, you have an item that you need to figure out what it does.
Is that it? Whoops. Yeah.
Why would you want iSCSI support on the Xbox One? What purpose would that
serve?
Yeah,
tell you what, let's go to test chambers instead, and I think maybe we can select levels from here. And yeah, let's go to an early level.
I didn't remember you could do that.
Yeah, so once you've actually reached the level in the main campaign, then you can jump into other level to the old ones.
Nice.
And I think there's even a level creator, isn't there, or something like that? I seem to remember those.
I believe so. I never really messed with it much, but I believe so. That takes a lot of effort to create your own level and things.
Yeah, I never feel like doing it either. Maybe I would create my own Bomberman level. And actually, I was really into the computer version of Worms for a while, and I did create some really cool levels in that. And I'm still proud of them. Like, I made this one level that's completely made of... It's a Bionic Commando level, and it's got, like, you know, the actual NES graphics and everything. It's just really neat.
Nice.
Yeah.
Cool.
Oh god, this is hard.
I did a little bit of creating in Mario Paint. I think that's the most video game creation I've ever done.
Hold ledge and tap B, I see. What? Let's try that again.
It is fun watching the little clones eviscerate or evaporate and just die.
Maybe next time. Oh. Test complete. All right. Add storage without nearby external hard drive. I mean, there's other... Ooh, I got an A for that. Not too shabby. So I think I've got...
Well, I suppose...
I've actually got either an A or an S on all the first level ones, except I didn't discover one of the hidden ones.
But
Yeah, there's like a hidden clone buddy in each level, I think.
Let's see you deal with this one. You get these messages on the back of the wall, and they can be pretty clever sometimes.
Yeah, I like that little presentation, and they have a bit of a sense of humor.
So I've got a clone with me, and he is helping flip some of the switches and stuff. So, again, were there clones in the first game?
I think so.
Because, yeah, they called it a Game of Clones, which is a play on a Game of Thrones. It's important to follow the rules. Yeah, I like following the rules. So, step on this one, maybe. Yeah, that's what it was. All right, now what? What's up here? I see. Yeah, sometimes you just have to find your way around through a little maze, and that stuff can be really clever.
Yeah, I can see how this would be.
Oh, I'm difficult. Not laughing, honest.
Oh. Sure.
So should I hit any of these? There's also a stealth component where you have to avoid cameras and enemies and stuff like that. Ah. All right, so we got that down. Now what? Oh, now I can use it to trip a switch. That's right. Yeah, we couldn't get any PC codes for this time. I did try, as always, but...
Is this big combo on
It's
PC?
Not...
Like this.
I would have been happy just to give out any one of them, you know? That would have been fine with me.
That's true.
So, yeah. Don't put the switch on... Don't put this on that. Instead...
Have a lot of Curves games been on Games with Gold? Because I know a lot of them have been on PlayStation Plus.
I don't know about a lot, but I feel like at least one of them must have been.
There have been a few.
Yeah, if anybody remembers.
I want to say Thomas Was Alone, maybe?
Seems like one that would have been.
I think it was.
Because for PlayStation Plus, Nova was free. Stealth Inc. 2 was on Plus. Swapper was on Plus, The Swindle was on Plus, and Thomas Was Alone was on Plus.
You know, Nova does not look any good to me.
It was okay. I don't like how they, like, obscure two-thirds of the screen.
Really? That much of the screen? What is it obscured with?
Wow.
It's just like, I mean, it's like that Fog of War stuff, so as you move forward, you kind of unveil it, but then it is just kind of annoying. I didn't like it, and I didn't think it added a whole lot. Because you still have to solve puzzles and stuff.
That seems like a bit of lazy development there.
Action Hank is fun, isn't
yes,
that
it
in
is.
This combo?
I hate the way they
yes.
spell Hank.
You could play that. Yeah, that's weird.
Hank.
You could play that. That would be good for stream,
Action
too.
Action Hank!
Like, I mean, that's easy to learn.
Nice. Yeah, too bad I don't have it. I didn't take a... I didn't take a code for myself.
That's right, I remember that now.
So.
Which makes sense, because you said you own so
yeah,
many of
like
them.
Yeah, like if I... only had one or two, then I would have been like, hey, can I please get a code too? But I had enough games to do the stream, and so...
Yeah.
Yeah,
what's next to you? Then we can have one more winner.
Yeah.
Go exactly. Talk to the... Yeah, there you go.
I'm trying to see. The only ones I haven't... So I own few, but I haven't played it.
It's so good, but it gets hard.
I own Ollie Ollie. And I played a little bit of it, but I haven't beat it. It's
yeah, that doesn't
too.
Look like my kind of thing.
I don't own Stick Bold, and then that's it. I've played and beat the rest of them. So I've played and beat seven of them.
Yeah, I think I own
good luck, everybody.
Five out of the 10.
Not too shabby.
Yeah, good luck.
All right, so I only got to beat that time. You know, it encourages you to replay the level and just don't make any mistakes this time. And, like, I did that for a lot of levels. It's quite fun. And...
Yeah.
Yeah, so, again, I'm a little out of practice, so we can't show you the more advanced stuff, but it is a really cool game, and you'll learn the mechanics organically as you play through the game, so I definitely recommend it. Now, what did I say would be next? Hugh? Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes.
By the way, guys, don't forget, we do these streams every Saturday of the year, unless I'm out of town, so every Saturday. Next Saturday, this is not completely solidified, but we're really hoping to do another Call of Duty Infinite Warfare stream. because the Call of Duty Infinite Warfare Sabotage DLC just came out on Xbox One. It had like a month PlayStation 4 exclusivity. But it just came out on Xbox One, and we are hoping to give out some codes for the DLC and maybe even the full game, which would be really neat. Like, Infinite Warfare is the best Call of Duty in years, but, man, people really shut their minds to it. Like, it being in a sci-fi setting, for some reason, that just rubbed a bunch of meatheads the wrong way. And also some nice people.
Yeah, I mean,
like, God forbid a sequel to a game that comes out every single year actually be different from the other games. But, yo, Adrian Torres, hey, good to see you. Good.
Hey, hey.
Who's the best character to use on Crypt of the Necrodancer? I know it's an off-topic question.
I mean, the easiest one to play is the Bard. Yeah, I recommend playing him as you're starting out and then switching to Melody after that, after you beat it with him. So here we are in Hue. Let's see. I got your color wheel mechanics.
Hey, what? Why does it... Oh, do you have colorblind turned on?
Do I? I guess I do.
Yeah, I think you do. The symbols, they aren't on normally.
Oh, yeah, that's right. But the symbols are kind of cool looking.
Yeah, that kind of looks really cool.
So you can see in this game you have the ability to manipulate the colors of the world and use that to solve puzzles. At first you only have like one color, and then you get more colors as you go on, and that just opens up the solutions to puzzles, and it lets you reach different areas and stuff. So it's a one big connected overworld, isn't it?
Yes.
Anything but blue.
It is a little bit of Metroidvania style, but not a lot.
Real nice art style. This comes from the guy who developed Mush for Windows Phone, which was a really pretty Xbox Live game.
Yeah. Cool.
Oh, wrong one. But yeah, boy, this is a challenge. You got to be really quick. I feel like the time component of it is not the best. I wish that time just completely froze when you were doing the color wheel, because there's a lot of other games where time does freeze, including Shantae.
Well, I mean, if it did that, then there would be no challenge on that puzzle.
I don't want that kind of challenge.
Yeah, I mean, part of the challenge is finding the colors quickly. Part of the
card games. He likes games that just...
I know.
Hey, man, I'm
together.
But part of the other challenging part of this game is picking the right color.
Plus, didn't you say they did make it so it's slower anyway?
They told me they did. It slows down, and it does give you enough time, but again, it's like there's just a lot to worry about at once, because you're worrying about the jumping, the actual solution of the puzzle, and then also just picking things fast enough, and sometimes I'm not able to do that. Let's see, what do I want to... Switch it to purple to make that go away. No, that doesn't make it go away. But I'm on purple. Oh, okay. I didn't do it.
You picked pink, not purple.
My bad. So then I want... Boy. Real complicated.
It can be.
Can't push this over the edge. Can I push this? Yeah, I can push this around. I can use it to get up on top of there. I don't even know why I want to do that. Can I? But I mean, again, they ease you into it when you're playing. This is what we get for just jumping into a bunch of in-progress saves, isn't it?
You want me to tell you how to beat this one?
Yeah, tell me what to do. That would be fine.
Okay, orange block all the way to the left, purple block in the middle, black block at the side, use them to jump over, grab the purple block that's up on the top left, push it down. Oh, sorry.
Okay, orange block, we want it in the middle, you said?
All the way to the left.
All the way to the left. How do we get it to the left side of the other stuff?
You have to push the other... You have to push the orange block to the left and then push the other two while the screen is orange past it.
Okay, that makes sense. Let's try that. Okay, so now I change it to orange, and the orange block will be there, and I can push it. No, not orange. Any other color but orange, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Correct. Okay.
Then I actually want the purple right there. So I made my little staircase, and then what do I change it to?
Yep. And then Jump up on the orange one, turn it purple. So you get rid of the other two, and then jump over there.
Just jump over where?
The little ledge with the spikes on top. Down at your head. Turn it a different color.
Push a purple down.
Push the purple down, yep.
Oh, follow it down.
Yeah, you can follow it down, that's fine.
Whee! Alright. Now...
And push it into the little gap there with the spikes. Yep.
Okay, so that's what I'm working on, is creating a solid pathway down at the bottom?
Yeah, you want to block on the left one and on the right one. The middle one you can just glide over. Okay, for the next part of the puzzle, you want to push... yeah, change it orange. You want to push the orange, or you want to push the purple one all the way to the right, black one in the middle.
Okay.
Don't care about the orange at this point.
I'm glad you still remember how to do all this.
Yeah. I played this game 2 weeks ago. Sweet. I'm currently streaming
it. So black in the middle.
And then turn it to a different color.
I'll be right
Turn it
back.
To blue, actually. And then push the black and the purple all the way to the right and use it to jump up and push the blue block down. Mm-hmm.
You're having trouble, Cleaner? That's a shame. It's really good to have you here. All right, now change it to anything but blue. All right, push the blue down. Yep. And I'm going to put the blue in the spikes. All right.
Yep. And then you want to push the orange, the long horizontal orange block. You want to push it over past the middle.
Past the middle, okay.
Yep. So you can grab it from the other side. You don't want it to be blue because you'll fall on the spikes.
I noticed.
So turn it to magenta, the pink color.
Okay.
So push it to where you can grab it from the other side, and then jump over and go to the other side.
If you insist...
Yes, I do. And then grab it and
grab
pull
button?
It.
Yeah, X. Okay, good. All right.
Yep. Pull it past the purple one and then turn it purple.
Oops. Oh, I see.
And turn it orange first and get yourself on the other side of the block. Okay. And then push
Got
it.
Got it. Thank
past.
You. No. Oh gosh.
Turn purple.
Paul.
The bad part
no.
about this game? There's no checkpoint. You gotta
that
start
is awful.
All over.
Oh,
yeah, it's a pain. That was something I wish they kind of had intermediate checkpoints. That is my biggest complaint about this particular game.
I'm completely with you.
But now you know how to do
the
puzzle.
But I am angry at the game. It shouldn't have made me angry.
Yeah, I can understand why you would be angry.
You wouldn't like me when I'm angry, game.
Yeah, I have a lot of issues in Edge myself. I want to like Edge, I really do, but it's got too many weird quirks still.
You know what?
Some websites just flat out don't work.
Here's what I don't like. When I go to Xbox.com... Oh, no. When I go to Xbox.com, with any browser that's not Edge, you get this huge use Edge nag at the top, and that is really obnoxious. Oops, I shouldn't have done that.
You get that with any Microsoft
website.
Yeah,
so Microsoft, that doesn't make me want to use Edge. It has the very opposite effect.
I can understand that.
Okay, I'm back. Hey, Paul looks like he's exactly where he was when I left.
He died.
Yeah, how do I get the purple block on the other side of the... Oh, I see. Yeah, I moved the black one out of the way. Yeah.
Just make it
turn
purple.
It purple and then... Yep, there you go.
I think I mentioned this last time, but IndieBox did a really cool IndieBox of this game for last month.
Cool.
And
by the way, Paul,
cool little collectibles.
You can push the boxes. Like, if you had the black one up against the purple one, you could push them both at the same time.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah, that's a nice little shortcut.
Jump into the spikes and see what happens.
I think I will.
He already knows what happens.
Yeah, but you know how forgetful I am.
That's true.
So who all got a Switch? Did you get a Switch, Brian?
No, there's one game, and I own a Wii U,
and you have
so...
a Wii U, yeah. There's really no reason to get the Switch for Zelda if you have a Wii U, based on basically everything I've heard.
It looks a little bit better on the Wii U. but not enough. Or it looks a little bit better on the Switch. Not enough for me to spend $400 buying a new
console.
And
as for me, I still want one, even though Nintendo did every stupid thing wrong with online, just like I predicted and like I think a lot of people should have predicted.
I think they're still working it out.
Blue.
I mean, Blue. Friends codes are back, guys, so that's all you really need to know.
Yeah, how is that even possible?
How could anyone?
Honestly, I don't mind that, because I don't like random people adding me on consoles.
Even still, it makes 99% of people mad. It's just bad. Let's see, what am I...
Push that into the spikes.
Orange.
Push the blue block into the spikes.
Yeah, push the blue block into the spikes, then get on the other side of the orange block, push it over,
I got to bed a little bit earlier than I normally do for these streams, but not earlier enough, because yesterday at the hotel I worked like a 10-hour shift and I had not had any extra... Anyway, I'm very sleepy, even though I slept kind of a decent amount, but those are the breaks.
I am not poor, shall we say, Maze.
Poor Brian. Poor Maze.
I'm not poor. I'm not rich by any stretch, but I'm not poor.
Out of everyone we know, you and Perfect Zero are probably the two most upper middle class people. Let's see.
Probably.
Perfect Zero, like, works way too much. He should give himself more time for hobbies. Sorry, Perfect Zero.
I don't. I try never to work myself to death.
Yeah, I mean, your job has, like, normal hours, right? And I don't, he takes on extra jobs and stuff on top of all that. It's like, that's just too much. Okay. So I want to move the orange all the way to the left, right? But I have to...
Yes, because you need to use it to get the key. I am a real big Zelda fan, and the new game is fantastic, but that's not what we're talking about.
I just don't see any reason why anyone would not like it unless you just plain don't like action RPGs. Because, especially this one, it's more like, they took a lot of inspiration from Witcher 3. Not like it has super great side quests like Witcher 3, but, I mean, just, the way it feels and looks. Very...
Yeah, a little bit. Okay, so you want the... You want the stack with the orange, purple, and black, because you need to get to the stairs. You got the key, the door's up at the top.
Okay, so change it to purple. No, that's not going to... You said I can glide over the middle one, you're sure? I can glide over...
No, don't do
you
that.
You can just walk around it.
You can turn it orange. So push everything to the side, all the way to the left. So switch it to a different color, and then pull whatever you can get.
Oh, pull the purple out of the way? Wait.
Yeah, pull the purple out of the way. Move it. So turn it magenta. Yeah, turn it magenta. Then pull the purple to the right. Then turn it purple and go
Sometimes,
past it.
Yeah, like just now, I think I'm picking purple, but actually the analog stick moves a little bit.
Yeah, it seems like there's a slight drift there.
That is my biggest complaint about this game. While I've been streaming it, it has done that to me no less than a dozen times.
Yeah, and that could result in your death sometimes when you're in one of those time pressure situations.
Yes.
Oops.
Definitely. You can actually leave the black one in the middle, how it's stacked now, and just push it over to where the orange is under the stairs, and then turn it orange, jump to the black, purple, turn it to a different color, orange, up. You're going to have an issue there.
Yeah, you went too fast again.
Okay, so push the purple and the black off to the right. The orange one's in the right spot. Push them off to the right.
Change purple, got it, yeah.
Change it purple, jump through to the black, and then change it to blue.
All right. Nope.
Yeah,
oh,
just something that's not the color, so
you
get three. Jump at the purple, it'll push it.
All right.
There you go.
Yeah.
And then black, and then up you go.
Ooh, Cleaner's excited for Mass Effect Andromeda. I think I might actually try to get that. That would be fun to stream.
I'm excited for that. I want that game, but I'm trying not to buy too many games right now because I just had to spend a whole bunch of money on my house.
We did it. And what's going
to... Woo!
And then we got a little story part here.
New color.
Is that a bad guy or a good guy, Brian? Do you know?
I haven't actually finished the game yet, but I'm pretty sure that's a good guy.
So, what's this? A new color.
I'm pretty close to finished. Yes. Blood red.
Hey,
I love the devil as the little shrine there. I love that it's a devil. It's kind of cool.
But yeah, I mean, I'm telling you guys, almost everybody would like Zelda if you like action RPGs. Achievement! Word! Caught red-handed.
Yeah, Zelda's awesome. It's just Nintendo that's not awesome.
That's exactly right. But like, even if you didn't grow up on Zelda, just trust, there's a reason why everybody likes it. It's not just because of nostalgia, it's because almost every single game is really good. So.
Oh, I forgot Ukulele's coming out soon.
Yes, it is in April.
Awesome. April. And don't let me forget to request that to review. Let's see what this letter says. Picked it up. Oh, here we go.
I'm already getting it. I bet.
So you've got some nice voice acting reading out the letter.
Yeah, the lady who does the voice acting for this, she's very good. Her voice is very pleasant. She reads the lines very well.
And the writing is good, too. You know, like, there's interesting things about color and just philosophy and stuff. It's very, you know, it's not just artistic looking, it's artistic in concept.
Yeah. Well, keep in mind, Icky, the Vita, or the Switch, is just as expensive as the Vita was when it first came out, and possibly a little cheaper, even. How much was the Vita when it came out?
$250, wasn't it?
Vita was $250 and $300, I thought.
I think it was $300.
$300 for the only so the 3G model.
The
3G.
Yes.
Oh, okay.
It was $250 for the version most people.
Okay, so it's $50 cheaper than the Switch, and the Switch is significantly more powerful.
Yeah, but it's also 5 years later.
And true. But another advantage is the Switch uses micro SD instead of proprietary memory cards.
Yeah. The silly storage.
That's
very
true. $100, 32 gig memory cards.
But
PlayStation
Vita's online system was designed by actual human beings and not primates.
Well, if you threw all three into a pile, the best one is by far Microsoft. Sony comes in a reluctant second, and Nintendo is a distant
third. But I mean, Microsoft
third.
Doesn't have a portable, so. You know, and the closest
that's
thing
true.
They had was Windows Phone, Xbox Games, and they butchered that as much as they could have.
Yes, they
Great
did.
Door. Okay, so what do we get out here?
Ooh, February. It's been a big month for games for me, and even the end of January, I just finished playing Neo, and then I'm getting Nier and LEGO Worlds on Tuesday.
Nice.
Sweet. So,
and I have Horizon right now that I'm playing through.
Jeez, you're busy.
Amount of games, yeah.
That might change, Extreme. I mean, everything with that system is still up in the air right now. I think they rushed it out to get it out so they could find out what all the bugs are and fix them before
And God
Christmas.
Forbid they should have actually planned their online component in advance like anyone else would have done.
But they have no idea how to do it, I think. They just don't know how to do it. What they should do is just look at Microsoft or Sony.
It would be so easy just to copy a competent existing system, but instead they do the stupidest possible thing and just fart their way through. It's so frustrating.
Yeah, I mean, I agree with DM John. He's funny. He says funny. He thinks it's a dead console. He's had it for 48 hours, and all it does is play Zelda, and it does that poorly. But, I think that their marketing has been a lot better than how they marketed around the Wii U. So I think it'll probably surpass Wii U sales, but I don't see it doing better than the GameCube did, which I don't think many people call a success.
Well,
it was
the GameCube,
pretty successful.
Just because it wasn't in charge, like it still got a lot of software support. There was a nice amount of third-party games and stuff.
Yes, it has a significant library. So this one, you want to switch the blocks down at the bottom.
Oh.
To any other
combination,
swap them. You know, play three card Monty with them, so to speak. You want to put one block over on the far left, so you can push down the orange one. You need to hop up there.
Wait, hop up where? What do you want?
You see the orange block up there on the left? You need to push that down. You need it. GameCube is a fantastic system. Some of my favorite games were on that system.
Yeah, but was it successful? Would you guys label it?
I would say it was. Yeah, I would say it was.
Okay, so just get it to purple or so, and
yep.
Okay, but I'll get over to where I want to go first. And
Yep, and then flip to red, and then you see how the puzzle goes.
I could actually, I'm having fun with this again, I could stick with this for the whole rest of the stream, but we should show off the swindle.
Yes, yes, you should. This is a very good game. It's very well done. The puzzles are maddeningly frustrating close to the end, because they get really hard. I really like this game a lot. This is nice. A+ for a platformer. Oh, this part.
Oh, you've got all these roly color-coded skulls. That's very interesting. Does the game automatically save?
Yes.
You know, can I quit now?
Yes, it saves at every door.
So that has been Hue, which again is a game that I recommend. Like, we're playing a lot of games that would be worth buying on their own for $10 or when they go on sale. Some of these games are 15, but anyway, you know what I mean? Like, they would be good enough at their asking price or their normal sale price, but you can get it, you just get them all at once. You know, get them all at once for $20, and that bundle is only available until $20. The 9th. What day of the week is the 9th?
Friday. Thursday.
Okay,
Thursday.
So that's your deadline for buying this, guys. And don't forget, if you want to support the stream, which is always something we're super grateful for, you can use our affiliate link, which we post in chat, or you can use the link in the article that accompanies the stream. But especially the affiliate link, if you want to buy it now, if you don't win, that would be a big help to us. And it's worth it. It's $20, and you get so many neat games. So now the swindle, which is going to be under T because of the poor alphabetization system the Xbox One uses.
Yes. That's a bummer.
The swindle. There we go. Excellent. A steampunk cybercrime caper. I played like...
I like the art style.
Yeah, it's pretty. Like, in-game, I think that you're a little zoomed out, so you don't get to appreciate the art as much, but let's just see how it goes. Yeah, the Switch does have a touch.
The Switch is touchscreen, yeah. And there's actually games that only work in portable mode because of the touchscreen.
Yeah, a couple of the ports.
But it's not going to be a lot of games, I don't think. Most games are going to be retail.
No new games. Yeah, I can't imagine they'll do any new games, unless it's like a silly little phone game that gets ported over.
What game are you talking about, DM, John?
DRM. If it was Steam, I'd buy. What game is he talking about?
I think all these games we're playing tonight are on Steam.
Each individual game is on Steam. The bundle itself is only on Xbox One.
Yes.
Scotland Yard will activate the Devil's Basilisk. Oh, and you don't want that to happen because it will make it impossible to be a thief anymore. Steal it before that can happen.
It's just 5 cleaner. We counted earlier. 5 out of the 10 games have been on PlayStation Plus.
Ah.
And then Ollie Ollie's sequel was too, but Ollie Ollie never has been.
But hey, even if you had those 5 on PlayStation Plus, but you also have an Xbox, it'd still be like, you know,
$4 a game.
So, still a good value. Hold Y, activate new heist. Is that what we want to do? Or activate workbench? What's in the workbench? Tyler, you know how to play this, right?
Yeah, I don't think you can do anything on the workbench yet, but the workbench is where you come upgrade things after you run
get
your
new skills and stuff. Oh, and now it's zoomed in nicely. Nice. Yeah, when it zooms in, it's nice to see the colors and the detail. Although the color scheme in general is too dark.
Well, at night.
It'll be brighter when you get to some of the levels.
And are there only 6 total levels? They're hard, right? Is that it?
Yeah. Yeah, you're gonna fail.
Wonderful. That's the spirit.
Yes. Very
Ollie Ollie launching down to the earth.
Yeah, and I do have Ollie Ollie. It doesn't seem like my kind of game at all, otherwise I'd play it on stream, but I'd rather play stuff that I'll be more excited about. 0 heist successful. It's raining, lots of parallax layers in the background. Love that. Let's see.
Ooh, very
I can
nice.
Return to the airship at any time. So is the idea that I want to collect some money and go back and get some skills?
Exactly.
Okay.
Cool. This looks a little bit like a very stylized version of Stealth Inc.
Yeah, you're right. This is a better art style. In fact, not that Stealth Inc. looks bad or anything. One thing is the activate button to open doors and stuff is the Y button, and that just shouldn't be. Hey, get over.
That's an odd button combination. Trouble fall.
I was having a little trouble not clinging to that. So. You have to avoid the cop's line of sight. Dang, he's coming all the way over here. You jerk.
Yes.
You open the door, man.
Another Mark of the Ninja-like. That's a good comparison, Oak Cigar. You know, the people who made Mark of the Ninja, Clay Games, they helped out with Crypt of the Necrodancer.
Nice.
They've made a lot of cool games. It's too bad they never ported Mark of the Ninja to PlayStation 4
and
Xbox One.
I wonder why they don't. You know, it's free money.
I don't either. I don't have any idea because it's super popular.
Put the window out. Is there any point to doing that?
I think it might make noise if someone's too close to you.
Because you do have your stealth components. My favorite game in this bundle? That's a good question, Raxi.
I would say mine would be Hue.
Yeah.
Out of all the ones I've played, I really like that
game. Yeah, I probably would have to go with Hue too. Although all the games that I've shown you tonight, I like a lot.
Swapper's a lot of fun too, but it can be tough. It's not
I have to admit, I own the Swapper. I just never played it.
Same here.
I need to play that.
Ooh, so I'm up on the ceiling. I'm taking a nice bath in the rain. Although, you know, there's also a lot of dirt in the rain, but still, it'll wash off a lot of debris.
Well, in London at this particular time period, there would have been a lot of sulfuric acid,
too.
So
if I make... If I break a window and the cop is anywhere nearby, what'll happen?
I don't remember.
Let's find out. Yeah.
Give it a shot.
Let him walk away a little bit. Oh, dang it. The jumping and...
The platforming is a little fidgety. It's not perfect. And that can be quite annoying when... Like, you screw something
break
up
it.
You didn't mean
Yeah.
Oh, I forgot about Thomas.
Although you're already
alone.
Facing the window on that one, so I'm not sure how
There's
you messed
no telling.
That one up.
Yeah.
Oh, crap. So I can just hide down here. He's not going to come down. Hey, I'm real good at messing things up, Tyler. Never underestimate me. So I guess we will jump down here.
Yeah. I would have to say, if I had to choose between two, it would be Thomas Was Alone or Hue. They're both excellent games.
I like Thomas Was Alone, but I didn't love it. It was kind of
It is a little simple, but the story and the narration is so good in Thomas Was Alone, and in fact, I should have streamed that a little tonight. I forgot all about it.
You streamed that one quite extensively.
Yeah, once, yeah.
True.
Yeah, several of these games we've given weekend streams to, but of course we picked up lots of new viewers and lost viewers along the way, so.
Very true, very true.
So do I have enough money to go back and buy an upgrade yet? Because I guess that's a big part of success, probably. Because I don't have the workbench skill, for one, so I can't interact with those panels.
Right, yeah, you can't hack yet, I mean, that's what things... I would just keep exploring everything
Dang
you
it,
can.
Tyler.
I don't think there's a time frame, is there?
I mean, a time limit? Yeah, no, there's no time limit.
Time limit, yeah.
There is a time frame. It's London, 1854. Okay.
Yeah. Okay, yeah, it looks like you're not getting down there anyway without explosives. I think you have explored everything you can.
So we'll go back and buy an upgrade. Good luck, everybody. And by the way, hello, Temporal Burn. Temporal Burn has an avatar image. Stands out from the crowd. Yeah,
nice.
Don't forget that, guys. Everybody make it your mission to set your beam avatar image. I don't want to see a crowd and no faces. Return to airship.
Yeah, you have to have an avatar image to win the contest.
That would be harsh.
You know, if you were a good, proper, smart Alec... Sorry, I had to correct myself on the fly there. If you were a good, smart Alec, you would go find an image of no face and make that your avatar.
No face is pretty rad. I would like to... we have the nice Hayao Miyazaki Studio Ghibli Blu-ray box set. It's super expensive. It's an Amazon exclusive. It goes on sale like as a gold box deal every now and then. And yeah, we have that, and we have Spirited Away in it. I really need to show it to my daughter sometime soon. So, stealth...
Spirited Away is so good.
Anti-G boosters. Oh, prevent fall damage. Oh, so we want to go to abilities or tools?
You definitely want to be able to hack. Okay. I think it's under abilities. That's the first one under abilities, I believe.
L100. Alright, we bought it. So now that means I only have, like, what, 50 money left or something? It doesn't show your money all the time, which is not good.
Yeah, 50.
It says
at the top.
Yeah, and so everything's going to cost more than that, I assume? Probably.
I think so.
Oh, yeah, some of these are expensive. Wow.
How much is 3,000? Whoa. What about just, like, agility? How much is agility? 600. Okay, we're going back. Do I keep these upgrades if I die?
For this run, yeah. Like, if you die, I think you just will come back to your base and you'll lose a day, but you'll keep that. But, like, I mean, you have 100 days, basically. Whoa. And then after those 100 days, you start over fresh.
Whoa, and so every time you go back, it uses a day, too. Just period.
Right.
Dang.
Well, I mean, yeah, like, every heist counts as a day.
I don't like that, but I understand why it must be. But yeah, that adds kind of a pressure element.
A little bit. Once you get good at it, it's extremely generous. And you're still on the first level, right?
Level
the
0.
Okay.
Oh,
yeah.
Let's go down. So I assume it's one-hit kills. The bad guys kill you in one hit?
I don't remember exactly.
Probably. It's not like it shows a life meter. Way to go, winners! But you're all a winner to me.
Just some of you are slightly more of a winner than others.
We don't say it very often, but, you know, we love all of you, all of you guys. Who are not evil. I guess I need to add that little comment to exclude certain people. Here we go. Alright. So, I already made a lot more money on this run. It seems to have increased how much the money's worth or something.
Yeah. Because you've gotten all the same money that you got last time, so I guess it's just more money.
Yeah, there must have been some bigger piles or something.
Well, I'm not going to complain. I like the Ferris wheel in the background.
Yeah, the background's cool.
Yeah, it sort of screams the Eye of London a little bit.
I don't know if I love the sepia hue of the whole game. I mean, I think the later levels are like a little bit of a different color.
All right, now I can hack. Let's do this. Run hack.exe. Press left.
Woohoo!
Press right. So there's a minigame element down. Woo! Dude, I just got a ton of money for doing that. So that pays off really fast.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. The hacking is what you... Like, it should instruct you to buy that first. I don't know why it doesn't. Because you need it.
Oh, I've been sighted. And the music changed.
Oh no! Oh, are they on high alert? Oh, they are.
So, now we know what it does. What happens.
Indeed.
Doesn't really seem to have spoiled things too badly.
I think you now have only, like, a few minutes until, like, the cops get there.
Oh, so that means you need to...
Head back towards your...
Yeah, need to bug out.
If the jumping into windows and stuff wasn't kind of bad, that would be nice. But
yeah.
Platforming's not perfect.
That's the kind of thing that they should have fixed with updates. Oh no, fall damage. Oh, I died because of fall damage, and I lost all that money.
Oh.
Oh.
Got an achievement, though. So close.
Dang.
Die on a heist with 100% of the loot. Another heist. Okay, let's try it again. Alright, well, that was the warm-up, wasn't it? I'm really liking this, though. I look forward to seeing how the game expands.
Yeah, it's cool. It gets harder, but...
Oh, are you a different thief now?
Yeah. Yep. Your last thief is gone. It's like Rogue Legacy a little bit.
Ah,
but you keep your upgrades, right? Hacking?
Yeah, you'll still be able to hack, I'm almost positive. Find out right now.
You have to refresh after you upload your avatar, Raxi.
Yeah.
Raxi.
Oops.
Ooh, another hacking.
And eventually, like, the hack systems, I think if you push the wrong button, they trigger alarms and things
like that, too. Oh, gosh. Makes it harder.
I miss my old thief.
This guy has a weird looking. Is that his nose?
Yeah,
that
I don't...
weird?
He's wearing a gas mask.
Oh.
Oh.
Are you my mummy? That guy.
Oh, that was such a messed up
episode. There's never... I don't know why there's a backyard. There's never anything back there.
And do I even have a way to get down? Because I see there's still some guys down below. But I didn't see...
Sometimes you do. It's randomly generated. Eventually you get explosives. So like when things spawn down there, you can actually get down there. But for now, like, you may not be able to access it.
I got a lot less money this time, so it is a shame that I died.
Yeah, it's. I mean, it's $300 less. You're at 1,100.
So but... I could just do another heist, or yeah, because do I even have enough for an upgrade? I think there was something for 600.
I can't remember. I think you could get a couple things.
Yeah, let's go get something. Why not? Let's see. We're not missing too much. Missing out on chat, are we? We're paying good attention, I hope.
All right. Nope. I'm talking to him. Don't worry.
Movement speed. Increase your movement speed. Or wall jumping.
And Raxi took it up. Took me up on my challenge and made her avatar.
Good job. Ooh, double jump.
Well done.
Right. Yeah, one extra jump. Yes. All right. So now I have 324. Not enough to buy anything. What about goggles? How much are they? Whoa.
Poor Adrian Torres. We've scarred
him. Goggles can be helpful.
Interesting. Yeah, they're all...
I think you actually have to... you have to actually buy in future levels. Does that make sense? Like, to get access to the clearance, which is the next level, you have to have $4,000. Oh, and then that next level... Like, I mean, you're only ever going to bank about 1,000 to 1,500 in these levels, and then the next level you'll get, like, considerably more. So that's where those super high values
come. So I shouldn't have actually bought the double jump yet?
I don't know. I mean, it could be helpful.
It's not going to be not helpful. I mean, it won't hamper me. That's what I mean to say. Man, I'm so tired. Right. So guys, I said this at the beginning of the stream, but don't forget, today we just published our big Resident Evil 7 speedrun guide at Windows Central. I'm so proud of this. It's over 5,700 words, something like that.
Damn,
yeah,
son.
I mean, because it walks you through the entire game, beating it in less than 4 hours. Every single step that you need to make is in this guide, so there's no guesswork. There's no figuring out, okay, what else do I need to do at this part?
Gotcha.
And so, I mean, it's everything you could want in a speedrun guide. You don't have to watch a video. To me, playing along while trying to watch a video, you know, pausing the video back and forth, that's really annoying. So, like, yeah, just to have a fully written guide like this. It's divided up into sections, so you'll know if you're in the right section, all that junk. And we really would appreciate everybody leaving a positive comment on that. And also, if you could share it around, like on Twitter or Facebook, things like that. That, especially Twitter, is a big help.
Definitely.
Get some money. Yeah, and I mean, I spent a week on that. It was a big project, but it worked out really nicely.
Come back when you get some money, buddy.
Because a big part of why we do these streams, like, obviously it's fun to stream, it's fun to meet new people, to, you know, see what our community is like. But a big part of it is promoting our articles. And, again, it's very personally important to me that my articles do well. That helps me stay employed and, you know, able to write other cool gaming-related things. So please do go read the articles that we're promoting in tonight's chat. And leave comments. If you don't leave a comment, we don't know that you looked at it, you know, so you gotta leave comments. It's not hard. It's free.
Thank you, Ricky.
Alright, so we got 2,000, another heist. We're just gonna do it again until we get 4,000 and then unlock the next level.
Yeah, I would try and save up to 4,000. Yeah, because these first levels eventually get very simple. Like, I mean, you've kind of got
different kinds
already.
Of enemies, though. Yeah, what is that flying enemy?
There
I don't
we
know
go.
What, I don't know what to do about that.
Super annoying.
Oh crap, they're on high alert.
Uh-oh.
What's that gonna do to me?
Good job, Paul, good job.
Oh god. But I gotta get some more money, I can't leave with just $5 or whatever I got.
8 pounds, jeez.
I assure you, I weigh quite a lot more than 8 pounds. Let's see.
I think I have about 12 pounds on my desk
yeah,
right now.
Yeah, I mean, like, even if you don't plan to use the guide right now, like, even if you're not in the process of doing a Resident Evil speedrun, please just look anyway, because that is helpful to us. I mean, you know, like, we need the hits, and we need the comments. No joke. Alright, well, yeah, I lost a lot of money from the hacking part, too. That stinks.
Yeah, so do you see how that happened? Like, it slowly started securing the money so that when you hacked it, you could only hack.
Yeah,
so
I wish
much
I had known.
It.
I'm just going to get out of here and burn a day.
I didn't remember that. Yeah.
Oh, no. Yeah.
You got... Oh, yep, the cops are there. Run, man, run.
Another heist. Let's try that again and do it better this time. Mace finds this one the most interesting.
It looks interesting. Yeah.
It's an interesting game. It's really a lot of fun, but it's very hard. I wasn't able to beat it. I was very mad, but I got to the point where I just couldn't take the frustration
that's
anymore.
That's a shame.
Takes a lot for me. Oh man, the last level is such a disaster.
You might want to just skip the dudes down there, Paul.
I did. Yeah.
Oh, you did? Okay, good.
No, man, he still saw me. Ugh, sorry. Yeah, maybe.
Turned around
maybe
right
I
at the end.
Skipped. Oh well. But I mean, I almost had it. So we'll just keep working on this. Somebody's. What's Extreme G saying about the ads?
The ads on the Mobile Nations websites are appallingly bad.
Sorry, guys. You know those ads are a big part of how we actually make money, and they pay us to, write more stories. So. I know ads in general are annoying, but I mean, just trust me, they do serve a purpose, even if they can be horrible at times. In general.
Well, it seems like there's nothing to do in this level.
Oh,
like,
man.
You couldn't...
There's a copper.
Yeah, you're right.
You lost eight.
At least I didn't have a lot.
Oh, wow.
Thank goodness for that.
Alright. Yeah, once in a while, the RNG... in the early levels, like, lock too much behind walls that you can't get through yet.
Yeah, I don't mind ads myself, but Gawker's ads for a long time were horrendous, so they got locked.
Yeah, I don't blame you.
Yeah, I mean, the only ads that bother me are intrusive ones. I can deal with just regular panel ads and things like that.
Yeah.
But the things that scroll across your screen, or like that are casually in the background, and so when you click to like scroll down or something, it opens up an ad. That sort of stuff gets annoying.
Yes.
I hate that stuff.
Maybe breaking the glass doesn't alert
them. Didn't seem to.
Maybe it's just that they can see through the glass, which gives so you can't like stand there and wait. Basically, maybe that's the.
Yeah, that's...
glass and...
Oh, yeah.
I think that might be right, Tyler.
And I like how you have to tap the glass to break it a little. If you're close to it, anyway.
Oh, man, that guy's taking his sweet time climbing up those stairs.
Yeah, he's a bit slow. And I like how they don't see each other.
The game has a... Yeah, there's no bodies. I love that there was, like, no, like, Metal Gear style where, oh, look, there's a body, now I'm on high alert because I didn't hide the body or whatever. That gets super annoying. In stealth games, but this one doesn't have that.
Oh man,
that's nice.
This enemy is going to be difficult to defeat, I think. Can we do it? I got him. Good. All right, now I can hack.
Diet Coke with lime. Nice. No time.
I had the last of a monster. I got up a little early tonight because I had to cook supper. So I finished off my monster, and now I'm out of water. Although I'm not drinking a whole lot of it right now.
Cool.
Yeah. Whoa! After you hit those flying drones, they bounce around a little.
Yeah, they zip around.
I don't need to kill that cop. We'll just let him live.
Nope.
Yeah, there's no money over there. Rum and Red Bull. That doesn't sound like a smart combination.
Oh, no, man. Like, I love me a mixed energy drink. An energy drink with some vodka.
Vodka and Red Bull are real good. I've never had it with rum. That doesn't sound good either, but mostly because of the rum.
I think rum mix is fine with
Don't you drink spiced rum?
Yeah, I do. But
What do you drink it with? Dr. Pepper or something? I forget.
Coke. Pepsi.
Pepsi?
The good old standard.
Pepsi. All right.
Yeah, no Pepsi. Yes. Ooh.
Ah, whoa.
Oh, I like Pepsi way really? More than Coke.
I have the exact opposite.
Yeah, that's really
feeling.
Hard for me to imagine. And it's not just because I grew up in the South or something. Like, just based on taste, you know? Oh,
well,
man.
Aren't you required by law to like Dr. Pepper?
Who, me?
No, Paul.
Well, I'm not crazy about Dr. Pepper, but yeah, my girlfriend and son both love it.
Everyone should love Dr. Pepper. It's the best soda.
It is good, but it's made in Texas.
Pepsi's not bad, but just Coke is significantly better, and also Diet Pepsi has serious aftertaste compared to Coke Zero.
They have changed Diet Pepsi. And it tastes weird.
Alright.
But yeah, I like Pepsi quite a bit more than Coke. It has more flavor to me.
Pepsi Max is pretty good, though. It's got a lot more caffeine.
I like when Muscanet says Pepsi tastes like watered down Diet Coke.
Oh, you have over 4,000. All right,
okay,
nice.
Let's go back to the airship.
Oh, nice. Good money.
Too much gas. Icky says Coke gives him gas.
Too much carbonation,
most people,
yeah.
You know, I mean,
I don't know.
Well, every soda will do that.
Yeah.
I wonder if they actually have varying levels of carbonation. Perhaps slightly varying. I never noticed, like, I never drank one and was like, this is extra fizzy.
There are some, like, ginger ales that are extremely fizzy. A little too much, though.
All right, we're trying the next level real quick. We're getting towards the end of the stream, so thank you all for joining us.
Hey,
yeah, we do have to quit in a moment.
Yes.
Yeah. By the way, speaking of Resident Evil 7, you know, like I said, I wrote that speedrun guide. I'm real proud of it. Don't forget to look at it. But also, I've told a few of you guys about this, but I have the unique opportunity to interview the guy who composed the theme song for Resident Evil 7. And... yeah, I've never interviewed a composer before, so it's going to be a whole different kind of experience. That was weird. What do these little hopping robots do? What's the idea with them?
I don't remember.
Oh. Scary.
Almost there.
It worked
Dang.
Out. A lot of different ways barely. To go here. Oh, dang it. And I died. another heist. Keep going
Spikes
for a little
on,
while.
You got, you Ooh. Got seen.
So who are you going to be?
81%
is how much I had on me.
No. Apparently, there's a vodka that's being recalled. Withheld says because it was 81% alcohol.
Strong. Isn't that like Everclear style?
You could run that in a car. Everclear is 98%.
Yeah. Why would you want your vodka that strong, man?
Wow. I think somebody might have made a mistake when they were distilling it. Forgot to add water.
Maybe. So what about this bruiser-looking robot? Oh, God.
I think you just have to hit him to it.
Okay, and you can't just whack away at them. You have to wait till they recover, it looks like.
Yes, I believe so.
Nice reference, Muscatanus.
Can you make money on Beam like you can on Twitch? Yeah, Windows Central makes money from people who like if you subscribe to us, you know, you can be a, what do you call that when they subscribe to us here? Yeah.
Subscriber.
Anyway, do that, which is...
it's followers. Followers, yeah. Followers is the free following, and then subscribers is the expensive one.
Yeah, $6 a month, you get access to the different emotes we have. I don't know if there's any other benefits, but that is how we profit. Also, don't forget, if you use our affiliate link to buy the Instant Games Bundle or whatever game we have that weekend, then we do get, like, I don't know, 5% or something from that, and that is really, really super helpful. Yeah,
nice.
So please don't forget to do that. If you're interested in the Instant Any Hits Bundle, go ahead and just get it using our link, and we will be so grateful. It's $20, you get the Swindle here, and 9 other games, easily worth the money.
Yeah, some of them are worth $20 by themselves.
Ah.
So, getting 10 pretty good games all together, that's a good deal.
Some are just pretty good, some are great. Ah, whoa. Dude, robot, Ooh. Don't look at me. Yeah, that robot turned... Oh, well, I don't have to... It's a little... But then I won't have 100% of the money. Is he going to turn around?
Is there money over there?
The guy's got money.
Oh,
yeah,
the Bruce
I would not go
Really?
Over
but
there.
Don't I need all the money?
Yeah.
No, okay, no. Okay. So it was actually 81 proof. Or 81%.
And wait, I've got a double jump.
Remember, you have the double jump. That's kind of what it's for. That's, I think, an alarm you have to disable.
So I can't, do that yet, or can I?
I don't remember.
Is it part of the hacking?
I can't interact with it. It doesn't even say anything.
Yeah.
Bear couriers. Oh. Because when you gotta send something, send it by bear.
Right.
So no particular reason to go here. Is that just a backyard area?
I would think you've got a bed. This is a bad place. I'm not seeing... Because I'm not even seeing the thing to hack. Yeah, once in a while that happens. It's drawback of the...
Yeah, the procedurally generated stuff.
And that's something that can be avoided with good programming.
Yeah,
true. Because, like, when I play Crypt of the Necrodancer, it's...
Well, I mean, did you still do that through the main area?
I mean, I can't, because...
There's a whole bunch...
I don't have a way to unlock these doors.
Yeah,
so that's a problem. I need the money to get the skill. Can't do it yet.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, like I said, the 100 days is pretty generous. I mean, after your third, fourth, fifth run, once you kind of get to know everything, it shouldn't come into play much.
I'm not earning more money in this map so far, Tyler.
Yeah, I've noticed.
Oh, so what's this thing? It's got a red light, laser light above it or something?
I think it's a landmine.
So, anything you can do about it?
Approach slowly?
I think you can run straight over it or activate it and step backwards real quick.
Yeah.
But, like, you just can't around that it.
That was neat, too. Cool effect. Holy. Sell yourself to the devil, Mace says. He's always trying to get me to do that, too.
Good money in it, I guess.
So this is the security thing again, and there's a robot inside, so no thank you.
Yeah, I wouldn't bother.
Alright, Young's Energies. That needs an apostrophe. By the way, guys, something I tweeted about last week, never pluralize with apostrophe. The apostrophe is not for pluralization. However you learned that, you were told wrong. Also, a lot of people, I don't think they learned it. They're just like, what's an apostrophe for? And they just kind of randomly throw them in while they're typing things. Like, no. Apostrophe is to show possession and for contractions. But that's it. Do not use it for pluralization. Thank you.
Yes. Apostrophes are for, I think you said contractions. Right? And ownership, possession.
So, and let me tell you why that's important. When you pluralize with one, say, like, instead of saying cats, like, you mean to say the plural of cats, but you throw an apostrophe in there because you don't know what apostrophes are for. When you do that, what it says to the reader who understands the rules of English, it says you're saying something belongs to the cat, a single cat. But that's not what you meant at all. Mm-hmm. So, like, why make your writing confusing? There's no reason to do that.
So yes.
Just learn the rule and you'll be so much happier, and especially the people who have to read whatever the heck you're typing will be happier. Oh, crap. Stupid flying robot.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, that sucks. Ah! What are you going to do about it? Yeah, that's what I thought.
Wow, that bruiser's cooking.
Man, I took care of him. It's about time to get out of here.
Is there money up on that landmine, or is that a little robot?
It's just a robot, as far as I can tell.
Oh, okay.
Ah!
I like the little slow motion effect that it has when you do that.
Good stylistic touch. Uh-oh, I don't see a way to get down there.
Yeah, you're not getting down there.
Oh, well, I guess it's time to go. Again, nothing to hack, so, like, these runs are just really wasting days.
There might have been something down there. You didn't get to explore the whole level, but it's also possible it wasn't.
Good luck with the raffle, everybody.
My favorite is proper use of a semicolon. Yeah,
you definitely need to...
Good luck with that.
When we were talking about the punctuation thing, I guessed that Maze would take advantage of that by pluralizing with an apostrophe. I knew he would do that. So predictable, you jerk. Alright. Okay, we're gonna return the airship because I guess we need to at least let the contest finish, but one more run.
Yeah, he's almost done.
Sure. Oh, I'm sorry, Jeff.
Somehow, I don't know if you have ever cried in your life.
He feels no emotions. That's mean.
The beard is his shield.
Okay, go work on that computer.
Computer? Where? Oh, yeah,
over
nice.
Here, right?
Okay, yeah, if I can. No! God! I'm an idiot!
He opens it right as the cop gets there. Hurry up and hack it real quick after you kill that guy.
Alright, I got 2,641 out of it. At least I can get some new skills with that.
Nice.
Yeah, the computers, I mean, the bags of money, the weeks that sit around are kind of important at first, but pretty much it only matters to the computers.
Hey, Gian Madras, don't say that. Could care less is a completely invalid expression. Yeah, it makes me so mad that... what's the main guy in Guardians of the Galaxy? What's his name? Sky-Lord or something? Star-Lord Peter Quill. Could care less is incorrect. It's couldn't care less. Could care less is essentially meaningless. Let's see. So, agility.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, anyway, Peter Quill in Guardians of the Galaxy, he says could care less, and, like, it's not communicated to the viewers that that's wrong, so that actually teaches regular people to say the wrong thing, so that makes me really mad. Because I know James Gunn knows better. It's probably meant to indicate that he's not especially educated, but it still has the effect of normalizing wrong use of the expression.
He was kidnapped when he was, close enough. He was kidnapped when he was a kid, so he was maybe in fifth grade, he might not have learned possessive.
But my point is the story needs to somehow communicate that that's actually uncouth, because otherwise it just teaches people to do it. Like, it really does. Well, every time you see it used wrong and you never learned the right way anyway, then it's teaching you to do it. Let's see, so I've got 2,000... 1,000. Bionic eyes. Allows the crook to see above and below by looking up and down. That's not bad. But we do need it.
the bug is really helpful if you go on to play this.
Nice.
More.
Yeah, you know, if I have a little time, I might try that. I learned it from watching you, Adrian says. My bad. You know, my background, my education is in literature, which is, you know, a branch of English. So, yeah, English is very important to me. I mean, it's adjacent to English, I should say. You take a lot of English classes, trust me. So, you don't need to be thought, only need to think a second about what it means. Yeah, I mean, well, just saying the wrong thing, yes, somebody can figure it out, but you're still saying the wrong thing. Like, you should say what you mean and mean what you say. But, you know, that's me. I'm a grammar dude. I correct people in chat and forums and stuff. Yes, that's my habit. Because I just would like for every... You know, to me, grammar matters. To some people, it doesn't matter at all. But that's okay. We're here to enjoy video games, dang it. So this was...
You're such a lit
This
nerd.
Was The Swindle from Curve Digital. All these games tonight that we featured were from Curve Digital. They're all available in the Instant Indie Hits Bundle for $20 all the way until March 9th on Xbox One. They're also on PlayStation 4 and Steam. Maybe even the Wii U, for all we know. But not as a bundle.
Some of them are.
So, thank you especially, Brian and Tyler. You guys are both great co-hosts.
Yeah, happy to be here.
Indeed.
Yeah, thank you, Icky, for running the contest. Icky is great at running the contest. So helpful. We'll see you next weekend, guys. Probably Call of Duty Infinite Warfare, but not 100% sure yet. We'll see how that goes. And whatever you do, don't hate. Appreciate.
See ya.
Have a good one.
Now I'll hold the little SOBs.